We have landed on the blue planet. Please activate your transmutation devices and take a breath. Don't trip. We have infinite time and space to complete your mission. Now, if anyone or anything ever has you up, you may return here to the center whenever you must. Just trust your purpose, your path, and always do the math.
I can go off if I want to. I can show off if I want to. I don't have to want you to love every part of myself. Got my confidence with no help. Don't need no one else to see that I'm the baddest in this beat. Yes, mind, body, soul is on fleek. Yes, equal beauty in the way I look and think. Yes, I'm the light. Now watch me shine bright. Celebrating elements to keep my mind right. That's right. I'm my own hero. Calling me a dime, but what's a dime to zero? I'm a full cipher. But no, you can't wipe her. Cause these days a fuck boy is hard to decipher. Self-love is all I need to find my inner peace. I see the pain decrease when I focus on me. Me,
me, me, me, me,
me,
me, me, me, me, me,
me.
I can arch my back through a back bend, and you can pay me back on the back end.
Cause you know a queen steps,
yeah.
And I get it from my mama, no past tense. Follow sequence and channel life down low. And if they have us fucked up, we some pharaohs. My mama taught me, believe that I'm the baddest in this beat. Yes, mind, body, soul is on fleek. Yes, equal beauty in the way I look and think. Yes, I'm the light that shines in the night. Celebrate the elements that keep my binds tight. That's right, I'm my own hero. I got the vision, reach you like a tarot. I'm a high beacon to heed to my teachers. Cause they silence our power, I'm breathing. Yeah. Self-love is all we need to find our inner peace. I see the pain decrease when I focus on me, me,
me, me, me, me.
When I focus on me, me,
me, me, me, me.
Could be selfish most of the time. I be selfish if I can't help myself. I know that I'ma be helpless. Always make the same mistakes. Heartbreak.
And if love is what you make, I have the tendency to give too many fucks and to gravitate to niggas rolling up, lift them up to the home. But it's like I'm building up my own throne.
It's your right to love yourself. You have to recognize. Be about it, pray about it, do your exercise. Baby, get fly, be the apple of your eye.
Be the sea, be the light, the sweetness in your life. Be the bark and the bite, the sugar and the spice, young star. You already know who you are.
Oh, yes. Peace and greetings, everyone. I want to say welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome to the remix. I am your host, of course, Ms.Blue, the Oracle, and you are live on the remix. I want to say peace and greetings to everyone out there listening, you guys, no matter where in the world you're listening from. Welcome to Planet Remix. Wow. So glad to have you guys in the house. Now, as we get ready to get into the cipher tonight, I want to do a couple of things. Number one, I want to let you know the blue room is open and it's already lit. So I want to say peace and greetings to everyone in the blue room. Thank you to Priestess Kalimar for opening up the way, Erica for sound check, Priestess Erica, and also thank you to Naima and all the rest of you as well. So greetings, 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 everyone. We're pushing through this solar eclipse energy, and my, oh my. It's a lot going on, still a lot going on. A lot of things for us to talk about as we get ready to get into the share tonight. Wow. I do want to give out the call-in number. Definitely, I want you guys to lock that number in. 515-605-9794 is the number to call so that you can get on the line and listen. If you're one of our international callers and you're calling from outside of the U.S., you know what to do. You have to dial the U.S. country code and then dial 515-605-9794. Mm-hmm. The blue room is open. I'm going to give you those cosmic directions to find your way on over. You're just going to come on over to YouTube. You're going to type in blue, like the color, B-L-U-E, Raz, R-A-S, Berry, B-E-R-R-Y. And that's going to get you locked in to the blue room. Click the link there and come on in. You can do that. And you can also listen via the phone. It's Friday, and we have so much going on. The solar eclipse energy is riding high. Shouts out to everyone. I see you guys getting yourselves in the blue room. We got Dr. Banks in the house tonight. We're going to do those shouts out really quickly. So sending love out to Dr. Banks and the whole family on the East Coast tuning in tonight. Wow. Sebek Ra Haru in the house tonight and family. Wow. R. Bailey in the house tonight. Shouts out to the blue room. I am Law 36 or 360, excuse me, in the house tonight. I love you guys' names every time I see that. So I want to welcome those of you, if this is your very first time listening or if you've been listening for a very long time. Either way it goes, you're always in for something so delightful when tuning in here. And it's good things that you can use while growing up on planet Earth, because that's what we're doing. Now you guys are shouting out, boom, shaka, laka, laka, boom, says she's been listening for over 6 years. Dr. Banks says for over 10 years. Oh, wow. Y'all are something else. I trust that you are staying cool because the whole planet is heating up. I felt like I wanted to come on and play a little bit of fire. Fire. I wanted to play fire because there is the temperatures are off the Richter scales around the globe. So much is happening from the fires, the earthquakes that are happening all around the world. And California, you just ain't stopped shaking yet. They're having back to back to back to back to back. California, Nevada is just over there doing the shake. They doing the shake. They are shook and still shaking. A lot of aftershocks happening and a lot of heat. So I spoke to a lot of you guys from Japan, did a reading earlier this week with the heat going on over there. And of course, a whole lot of other stuff going on, as well as earthquakes happening there going all the way. And if you notice, these earthquakes are getting a little bit more intense as we go along. 6.9, 7.3, 7.1, 7 point, you know, it's just going and going and going. Don't say we didn't tell you that. And we definitely have heat waves happening across the globe everywhere. Record number temperatures all over from Europe in the heat across the United States. It is sort of blanketing itself in the 100s and it doesn't look like relief is coming up. And let us not forget, because I know a lot of you, we've been talking about this, and this is something myself and Brother Bilal, we've been speaking to you guys and kind of preparing you for this for a minute. Area 51, UFOs, unidentifying flying objects everywhere. Pay attention to your dreams. And as Brother Bilal says, keep your eyes to the sky. It's a lot going on. I want to send some love, and I want to do this really, really quickly. I definitely want to send some love out to Puerto Rico, some special love out to Puerto Rico. I was speaking to a sister, did a reading for her this week in Puerto Rico. Protests going on. Crazy, insane protests. That's happening in Puerto Rico. And it's getting pretty intense. You know, this is a very active month. It's a very emotional month, this month of July. And of course, you know, this protest that's going on with the government over there in Puerto Rico. But this isn't new. These are a lot of things that are festering from a very much earlier time. As you know, as far as the colonized world go, Puerto Rico is one of the oldest colonized world. Did you guys know that? It used to be part of Spain. And it wasn't until, I think, 1898, the Spanish-American War, when the U.S. sort of took over Puerto Rico. But yet, we still look at Puerto Rico as it's something foreign. But that's not true. They are citizens of the United States since 1917. I mean, that's a whole nother story because we needed them to fight in the war with the Panama Canal, but I digress. We don't have time to talk about that tonight, but we do want to send them love and send them light, as well as all of you guys out there. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, greetings, greetings, greetings. Oh, Gas Draws is in the building tonight. We have Priestess Cinnamon in the house tonight. We have April Christine is in the house tonight. Amber is here tonight. Peace and Love Remix Family sends shouts out. Goddess M is here. She said, learn something new every day. Absolutely. Naima in the house tonight. Welcome, 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 you guys. Priestess Sunflower in the house tonight. And let me not screw your name up. What is this? Patton Jael. Peyton Jael in the house tonight. Peace, everybody. M. Harper in the house tonight. Greetings. Dakita is in the house tonight. So many of you guys. Well, as you guys know, XYXOXY is in the house tonight. Priestess Shakesha in the house tonight. Oh, man. Y'all are filling up in the house tonight. Watershed rolling papers. It's a watershed moment for sure. Diamond Love in the house. I love you guys' name. Diamond Love. I really like that. That's nice. Zuri Jury is in the house tonight. Wow. Y'all are doing it up. Well, tonight we have a very, very special guest. Known by many on the planet, but for the few of you who don't know, tonight we have Dr. Wayne Chandler. He's going to be joining us here tonight, and he definitely is no stranger to Planet Remix. He's been a guest many times before, but it's been a while since he's been on, so we are truly, truly honored to have Dr. Wayne Chandler come on tonight, Brother Wayne Chandler to come on tonight, and talk to us tonight about the alchemy of inner power and some exciting things that he has coming up that many of you probably will love to dive in and take part in. So we're going to talk about Brother Wayne Chandler in just a moment. We'll be bringing him on shortly. Of course, you know, we're going to do what we're going to do here on Planet Remix as we ease our way into tonight. But Dr. Wayne Chandler is on, and, you know, we're going to get into that in just a minute. I kind of want to save the good goods, and I really want to have him on the phone when we talk about that. So in the meantime, what I want to do is just send love out to each and every single one of you. Welcome, 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 as you guys begin to come on in. And the Blue Room and on the phone lines. I see you guys. Shouts out to Priestess Chastity in the building, Priestess Melanie in the building, all the priestess here. So let's just go ahead and give a big shout out to all the divine priestess out there doing your work. Welcome. The other thing I want to do is ring the bell. That's right. I want to ring the bell for Self-Invested. And as you guys know, we are getting ramped up for the new session of Self-Invested that starts in August. So if you want to find out details, if you want to be a part, questionforblue@gmail.com. Everything's available in the show notes. Do it. Do it now. Because seats are filling up. And they're filling up pretty fast. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Shouts out to Brother Bilal. I know he's listening in, sending him so much love as well. And the family, Brother Bilal, sending him love. Dr. Banks, who's joining us also in the Blue Room. So shouts out again to him. Sister Munya, Baby Nine Eye, Tiwi, the whole crew, sending them love as well. And all of you. And let us not forget the seen and the unseen. Yeah. Yeah. We can say that, right? Can we say the seen and the unseen? I could say something else, but we'll leave it at that. So now what we're going to do, because we need to get our minds right for Dr. Wayne Chandler, who's coming on tonight. Amazing brother, built with so much wisdom, a true master on the planet for all of us. And, a lot of things. We're going to be doing a live activation here tonight. So I really want us to just kind of focus a little bit. It's been a busy week. I've been getting your emails, talking to you guys, and I really want us to get into a great space for us to just receive this message. And I want to send love out to my sisters. But tonight, I really want to focus on a message and send just that extra little boost of love to the brothers, because you need it right now. You need it right now. I want to send y'all some love. And oh, by the way, shots out. Don't come for me. Shots out to our president of the United States. Shots out to him. It looks like he's going to be very instrumental in helping our brother ASAP Rocky to get out of prison in Switzerland. And shout out to Kanye West. Now, love it, hate it, whatever, we need to make sure ASAP Rocky comes home. I digress. I digress. But I want to send a shout out for ASAP Rocky. Hopefully he can get back on U.S. soil and we can understand that people do things different in different countries. But that's another show, whole nother show. We'll talk about that another time. Don't come for me. Don't come for me. Okay? Shots out. We just want to get him home. We don't care how he get here. He just needs to get back. That's it. We're going to do our PSA because I think it's going to get a little sticky tonight as we get into the share. Yeah, let's do that. Greetings, everyone. Hi, it's me, Ms.Blue, the Oracle. And of course, you know that it is time for Planet Remix. And we are about to get fully plugged into the cipher. And so I want us to be responsible while knowing our magic and growing up on planet Earth. So, if you have any minors around or anyone who may be a little sensitive to a little bit of language and certain content, this will be the great time for you to go grab some headsets and get plugged in like the rest of us. So, put the babies to sleep, let the dogs out, let the cats run free as we get ready to dive into the cipher. We cover so much content and information here, tools and things that you can begin to use, but we do it with a lot of adult content. So let's be responsible while knowing our magic on Planet Remix. Simply there's no other way. So, enjoy the cipher. Enjoy the share. And keep knowing your magic. And be responsible while growing up on Planet Remix. Oh, yeah. We're plugged in. We're plugged into the cipher. Fully plugged in.
Yeah. Fully plugged in.
That's right.
We are so plugged in to the cipher. So we're going to go ahead right now, and we're also going to listen to a little bit of Baby Blue, and we're going to talk about the vibes so we can get ready to get deeper into the share tonight. Here we go.
La 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 la, the remix. Hey, this is Baby Blue. And remember, if nothing else moves you, life will.
It is so true. Say it with me. If nothing else moves you, life will. If nothing else moves you, life will. So, we're going to listen to something that it just dropped last month. Yeah, I think it dropped last month. And we're going to listen to this. And this is really a dedication to all of us, the first half, and definitely a dedication to all the brothers out there. And just, you know, for us to stay on our path, have those reminders, you know, sort of whispered in our ears and very close to our hearts sometimes when we just are facing some obstacles, challenges, or just going about our way. So we're going to listen to this. I want you to tune your ears in as we get ready to welcome our dear brother, Dr. Wayne Chandler, to come on the platform. Also, if you have not liked and subscribed and you're in the blue room, I encourage you to do that and hashtag Planet Remix Radio everywhere. Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, social media, everywhere. So yeah, here we go.
In a hospital with incompetent doctors who didn't bother to press you against your mother's chest. But that's okay, cause Jehovah say that your mother blessed, and we are here to guide you through life and teach you what is best. Do not have your kids in a hospital, they don't give a fuck, especially about black folk. Learn how to deliver your own kids and have them at home, kid, and leave that placenta attached as long as you want, kid. It's different for black boys, harder for black girls. Start your own business venture, thrive in a black world where you and your homies don't gotta worry about getting fired and facing discrimination. We are creators, we don't go begging for placement where we are not wanted. And I'ma keep it 100, youngin', we used to be hunted. They had us sitting in zoos, so what you see in the news is really nothing that's new. They really targeting you, you hear me talking to you? But even if your bread's straight, big house, nice car, gotta keep your head straight. People that be gossiping constantly, only dead weight. Wiser assessments of situations will carry you to your best days. Put away a portion of your profit when you get paid. And do not be afraid of change. It could be a segue to a better something. But have patience and always make time for family and celebration. And every good thing in life requires dedication, like career, wife, kids, and the spiritual. The point of our existence isn't physical. Make sure there is love in your living room, and make sure that you're there for the ones that you give it to. And grudges will do you no good. Life is too short to be stressing. Love your friends for who they are. If they there when you down, then you should keep them around. And then return their favor tenfold. Everything you hiding will be exposed. So you should probably keep it 1,000, youngin', and let go. Embrace humiliation, it's humbling. And take every situation for what it is. Love is free, so don't be possessive. Love is a combination of letting go and holding tight. You'll learn when to do which and get more love than you know what to do with. And you gon' make mistakes, cause homie, you only human. But that ain't no excuse to be foolish. Treat your woman with respect, that means keeping it real, keeping her in your mind. If you about to be stupid, just think about how she feel. Be honest with yourself, put your ego on a shelf, and I promise you it helps. You ain't gotta be what they expect. Get to scrubbing when you make a mess, and treat your daughter same as your sons. We growing out of double standards, speaking the standards. Let's move away from the European. Tell her she's beautiful, wide nose, coarse hair, brown eyes, brown skin. Self love for the win. Why conform to a society that hates you? Spent all their energy trying to break you. Now they thinking y'all niggas still here. Yeah, y'all still scared. Black boy still strong, slavery still here. Black boy still marked, the prisons are still packed. We're innocent black boys, the black boys still thrive. The black girl still God, yeah.
Hey, how are you?
I love you too.
I love you too.
My big boy.
One thing I know.
Queens. Yeah. And that was Black Boys, Black Men. Wow. As we get ready to welcome Dr. Wayne Chandler to the platform, as he's joining us here live in the forum tonight on Planet Remix. Peace and greetings. Brother Wayne, how are you?
I'm doing well. Doing very well.
Wow. So good to have you in the house tonight. Before you get ready to get started, I do want to kind of give you an introduction for those who may not know. It's so much we can say about Dr. Wayne Chandler, I can say personally. Many of you know him. He is an author, a master teacher, an artist who has traveled all around the world and done some of those things that many of us have aspired to do in our life, and that is to be the first. And as you guys know, Brother Wayne Chandler is the author of Ancient Future, the Teachings and Prophetic Wisdom of the Seven Hermetic Laws of Ancient Egypt. If you don't have this book, run, don't walk, and go get it. And we'll talk more about that. But that was definitely a first. Many different disciplines, everything that deals with energy, healing, the mind, the body, the spirit, from yoga, from Qigong. Wow, Brother Wayne, you've done the most. And everything from
trying to stay busy.
Yes. Oh my gosh. Like, I could go on and on and on about all the different disciplines you've done. But seriously, because some of them, from some of the other great masters like yourself that you've been taught by, trained by, all across the globe and from so many different countries. And I'm actually finding out things I never knew, like you were on the kickboxing team and the Uganda kickboxing team. And you actually went to Africa to train some techniques. And I know you've traveled all over the world with your speech and your lectures. You've done a CD compilation with a producer. You know, man, listen, this is Dr. Wayne Chandler, Ancient Future. I think that sums it all up. So peace and greetings to you. How are you doing?
I'm doing very well. You know, we're also rolling through, some pretty serious temperatures here. Supposed to be 106 tomorrow. So,
wow.
And one of my best buddies is in town. He's having his birthday picnic tomorrow. So I told him, I said, man, it's going to be 106 degrees tomorrow. He looked at me and said, hey, I'm from Florida. I don't care, you know. But it's a really great festive occasion. People that we grew up with, that we came up with, they come from all over the world. You know, just for this one particular occasion.
Yeah, beautiful. Well, I absolutely love that. I know I want to talk about this at first because I think that this will definitely give some insight to where you are now and some of the things you have coming up. And I want to talk about first, before we get there, I want to ask you about the energy on the planet at this time. And what have you seen in your work and your travel about what is sort of needed most at this time for all of us?
Ah, that's a good question. What's needed most really is, from what I've seen and what I've experienced, is for individuals to cultivate a daily practice, an internal practice. And that speaks to the actual movement and integration of one's internal energy, one's internal life force, because the energies that are moving in from cosmic spheres and impacting the Earth you know, are having a substantial impact on all human beings on the earth. And a lot of people are having reactions, and most of those reactions, I guess, would be classified or categorized as negative reactions. Heart palpitations, you know, headaches, feeling feverish, aching joints, low energy.
Yes.
You know, and a lot of this is because the amount of energy that is being poured onto the earth right now, so many individuals, their channels are not open enough to really absorb and move that energy through, and it causes congestion.
I love that. And I like that you're speaking to it from a physical aspect, because we know that we are multidimensional. And so energy does affect us on so many different levels. And, you know,
exactly.
Just to be able to hear that and to know a lot of points of people with throat issues, which I myself had a couple of weeks ago, you know, throat issues going on all across, like so many different reports of people having throat issues that are going on. Like you said, the back pains, the heart computations, you know, things that when you're going to the doctor, they really are sort of almost clueless in a sense, like they can't pinpoint exactly what it is. That's always an indication. But if you could, Brother Wayne, we tackled the physical. Can you talk to how this energy is impacting our emotions? Because we know they're all tied in together too. Yeah.
Yeah, no question. One of the main, you know, just I don't want to like put negative connotations, because it's all about transformation.
That's,
you know,
correct.
I mean, in its essence. And so when you look at what's transpiring emotionally, you know, it's about how these frequencies are moving in and around the planet, impacting DNA.
Yes.
And so as the DNA and the codons are activated and begin to, you know, expand based on these intense frequencies, you know, that are moving in and through the human body,
mm-hmm.
it creates, once again, you know, a lot of shifts and emotional turmoil.
Right.
Because
I call it mental disturbance.
No way,
if you're not prepared to handle it, it can be.
Exactly.
This is what I think. And I want you to share your take on this, Brother Wayne. It's something we talk about here a lot. I believe that this is what's causing a lot of the mental disturbance on the planet, because people are so unaware, and we're almost living in three different dimensions. We have a physical, we have a mental dimension, and we have an emotional one. And so until we learn how to bring those three together, like you said, and really understand ourselves wholly, it's causing so much of this mental disturbance for those who are out of balance or unaware.
No question. You know, we don't have a roadmap which details exactly, you know, where we should go and how we should integrate with what it is that we're feeling.
Mm-hmm.
And because of that, because we don't have that type of a roadmap, you know, we end up, you know, really moving into places of resistance. And there's a lot of resistance right now to the degree of energy that's moving through the body. And some of that resistance is conscious, and some of it is very unconscious.
Mm-hmm.
You know, some of it is based, you know, in just how we live our lives and the type of congestion and blockages that we've created, you know, within the emotional body. You know, I mean, right now, DNA is really, really a lot of the frequencies coming in. That's their specific job, you know, is to
just
really activate and expand, you know, in substance, you know, and quality, the genetic impression and signatures, you know, that we carry.
Right. And so what does that look like on the surface? And I'm going to give you an example of what I mean. Like when you talk about that resistance and, you know, we see so many things being played out and we can use these stories, unfortunately, unfortunately, that we see happening on a big scale. Like I talked about during the opening about the protest that's happening in Puerto Rico and some of the protests that's even going on here and in Japan and, you know, these things that are happening, some of these very, very unthinkable crimes that people are doing, and just the way that we're using social media platforms, because now that's a tool that's available to everyone, and we're seeing people act out in so many different ways. How is what's going on at a subatomical level and universally or cosmically, how is that being played out on a grand scale in the world that you've seen?
Very profoundly, you know. I mean, you get into, once again, you know, one of the things that as human beings we tend to forget because we spend so much time walking through and engaging the earth and its various processes, we don't stop to think and remember how much of a cosmic entity we really are, you know. And so you get into the significance of just the planetary influences based on the seven rings and how each particular frequency of the specific planets that are moving around our solar system right now are having specific impact upon consciousness, upon you know, the DNA in the body. And each one of these particular planets, they are projecting cause and effect. They are directing a very specific direction regarding destiny for humanity.
Right.
And the need for that destiny to move humanity into a totally different frequency that's all about becoming something other than what it is expressing right now. So that is played out in the various, you know, countries right now where there are protests, and on individual levels, you know, where there is, you know, just a lot of concern regarding how people are processing information and dealing with that within relationships, dealing with that in their everyday work modes, dealing with that in their everyday just life occurrences, you know, however those may look for specific individuals.
Right.
You know, but there's an ongoing movement that is about really a transcendental, you know, opening and movement into different space and frequency.
Wow, that's powerful. So, question. What is alchemy? We hear that word a lot and we talk about it, but for you, what is alchemy? Let's talk about that.
Changing lead into gold. So in a three-dimensional construct, which is what we live in on a daily basis, it's not who and what we are. So our core energy is fourth dimensional. That's the nature that we really are calibrated and designed with in terms of how we want to express ourselves and be an example of that fourth dimensional frequency. But we're locked, you know, we're incarcerated in a three-dimensional infrastructure,
which limits
our ability to express our fourth dimensional dynamics. So turning lead into gold, mm-hmm. as it relates to alchemy, is being able to live in the three-dimensional construct, knowing that you're a fourth-dimensional entity, and doing the necessary cultivation practices that awaken, enliven, and activate that fourth-dimensional self, and that you begin to live and express that fourth-dimensional dynamic in a three-dimensional infrastructure.
Mm. Wow. I absolutely love that. I want you, Brother Wayne, if you could expound upon when you say three-dimensional for those listeners who may not understand. Because, and the reason I say this is because we have so much information being bombarded in our world. And there's so many different definitions of what third dimension is and what fourth dimension is. And you said something interesting. You said we are incarcerated in this third dimensional world. And it made me think about something, two things. One, it made me think about the movie When They See Us. Have you seen that?
When They See Us. Is it an old movie?
It is not. It is about the five young boys who were locked up and sentenced to prison, and they were later got released. Ava DuVall did it. It was a Netflix that just came out. The whole world is talking about it.
Right, okay.
Yeah, When They See Us. And I thought about them being incarcerated for so many years for a crime they didn't commit. Being incarcerated, right? Locked up, which is not a story that we haven't heard. It's sort of this ongoing theme that is happening. And I thought about what it took for them to get free. Like their whole lives. They went in when they were 13, 14, 15-year-old boys, and they didn't come out until they were older men. The Central Park Five. Thank you, Brittany. They did not get out until they were late in their 50s.
Right.
So if it took that long for them to get out of this incarceration, how do we begin to get on that path to move from the incarceration of this 3D world, which I'm assuming is the physical world, and moving ourselves to this fourth dimension of understanding while still living in a 3D world?
Again, you know, it really goes into understanding or developing an authentic understanding of one's internal energetic anatomy. Mm-hmm. And exactly, how that works.
I want to say this for the people in the back, Brother Wayne Chandler. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you. Mm-hmm. But when you say understanding your internal landscape, your internal operation, what does that mean? What does that mean for people who don't know? What does that mean?
Yeah, your energetic anatomy is really how you're wired as a fourth dimensional entity. Mm-hmm. So that means we're talking about chakras. We're talking about the meridians, you know, or the nadis, you know, that run through the body that carry a very specific frequency of energy that enlivens the body.
That's right.
And the ability to do specific practices, which activates and takes that particular life force, that particular frequency, and you use it to open, to unlock other doorways that gives you abilities and levels of self-empowerment that allows you to manipulate the three-dimensional realm that you're navigating.
Mm-hmm.
So the three-dimensional realm is the mundane. It's all that we know to be tangible. But in this particular instance, the three-dimensional realm is when I use it as a expression of incarceration, it's something that has been put upon us, integrated within us, for the sole purpose of limitation.
So would you be talking about
the fourth-dimensional aspect?
Would this be things that we've been indoctrinated into, things we've learned from our family, from schools that we've went through, from different religion and social groups, our environment
that is
around us?
Yeah, I mean, all of those things are an extension, you know, of a particular formula that has been implemented, that has been at play, you know, for quite a long period of time.
Right.
You know, and speaking of time, that's really what it began with the manipulation, you know, of time.
Mm-hmm.
And looking back on how the calendar, you know, was once a 13-month, 28-day calendar.
Right.
And this particular design was utilized all over the world, because what it did, it locked humanity and maintained humanity within its fourth dimensional framework.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so it was connected to its connected humanity into its intuitive, its psychic, its telepathic powers and abilities,
right,
you know, that were always expressed via the moon. You know, so it was a lunar calendar, you know, that was adhered to, and it kept humanity really integrated with a fourth dimensional construct that allowed that inner power, that expression of self-empowerment, that expression of personal power to always be forthcoming, and the individual to be able to manipulate or shift, you know, or recreate their realities as they saw fit in a three-dimensional realm.
Right.
And,
you know,
and that's something we no longer have.
Mm-hmm. And when you say that's something we no longer have, meaning, what does that mean when you say we no longer have? We no longer have.
We don't have the constructs around us that purposefully give us the freedom to move in directions to create the kind of realities for ourselves that we wish to create, or to even make us aware that we have these types of choices.
Right.
And options available to us.
Right. And I understand you're talking globally, because, of course, you've been on Planet Remix for a while. So, you know, our listening audiences are very in tune, the majority of them. So we are aware. But even for those of us aware, right, there's still a struggle to get outside of that, even when we know that, and to be consistent in that work. To be consistent.
Definitely. consistency is probably, you know, one of the greatest challenges, you know, that individuals, you know, can create, because they have the belief that what they're doing is something outside of extemporaneous to what their real life purpose is designed to be.
Right.
And so they look at it as something that they have to find time to do to help really move the rest of their reality forward, you know.
But when something goes wrong, then we want to go back to it. Yeah. Yeah. We treat it like,
you know,
medicine.
So exactly. And that's not really what it is. It's a design of self-empowerment that allows individuals to really reshape, repattern, and redesign their realities to create the realities that they wish to have for themselves.
Yes.
It allows the attraction of abundance, you know, mm-hmm. in its various shapes, forms, and fashions. You know, so when I talk about time and I talk about the calendar, you know, yes. these are constructs, you know, that were created to really move us away from elements of ourself mm-hmm. that gave us that ability to do those specific things. I just pulled this one piece, if I can read this very
oh, yes,
quickly.
Certainly.
This is from a piece called the Dream Spell Codex, you know, which is a translation of a Mayan document. And it says, imposters, male priests and warriors usurp the power of the 13 moons, which are the 13 months. They hid the 13 among themselves and attempted to banish all memory of the dream spell matrix of magic. The human race, the planetary kin, had imposed upon them the diminishing power ratio of 1260. No longer the magic of the 13 moons, but a 12-month calendar of uncertain meaning. No longer the timeless experience of magical flight, but a 60-minute hour to earn one's bread. Time was compressed into a flat circle. Instead of the 1328 ratio already stored deep within the crystal core of the Earth, the human race received the 1260 ratio, the dark dream spell of history, and the 13th moon or month was dismembered and added on as extra days to the calendar of 12. The absorption of the 13 by the 12 was called an improvement by the male imposter priest, hypnotized by the combined powers of Jupiter and Saturn. While the 12 diminished the power of 13 by 1, the 60 raised the power of 20 by 3. A seeming increase in power occurred, but it was only an increase on the flat plane of three-dimensional time to which the human race was now entrapped. With the banishment of the 13 moons, the fourth dimensional time magic became the property of the priest class, setting up religions and governments to maintain humanity within the third dimension. The priests were assured that anyone having fourth dimensional experiences either be appropriated or destroyed.
Mm.
So basically, what this piece is saying, that anyone
That's right.
who is stepping out, who has created a system of true, authentic liberation for individuals to embrace, that those individuals will be dealt with in a manner that, you know, will be, you know.
Yeah, we understand, but, you know, hey, Dr. Wayne Chandler is still standing and helping us to understand this knowledge. So I love it, but very powerful, because this was done throughout time. I know that piece was from the time of the Mayans, but that also ultimately happened in what we call ancient Egypt, Kemet as well too. That happened there. We also seen that happen in Europe with the women who they thought were practicing witch or sorcery. We see that now
right.
in ancient times when anyone gets to talking about hoodoo or voodoo. We see that coming up now. And even in our society, when you start to talk about energy and when you leave the physical and you start to talk about your chakras, your irites, or all of these different things, people start to look at you kind of with that side eye or, you know, this kind of thing. But it's interesting that that code was so embedded, like you said, because there are some things that have been passed down through our DNA and not just from our family code, ear to ear, orally, but also internally, like built inside of us to be fearful. I call it being afraid of who you are, afraid of your intuition or your inner power. I have a question for you, because so many times I encounter, and I know you do as well, people who are new to the path, and that's sort of their blueprint that they're holding, or the program that's running in the back of their head, that anytime they start to dive deeper into understanding themselves or getting that empowerment, they start to become fearful. How did you get started on your path? What was that beginning like for you?
I guess I was just one of those kind of fearless individuals. I mean, as a very young boy, I really wasn't locked into humanity that deeply. I was my focus was nature, you know. Mm-hmm. So my focus were animals, insects, things of that nature. When I was in elementary school, my nickname was Dr. Bugs. Yeah, I know, I hated it. But anyway, I had to live with it up through the fourth grade until I moved.
Oh, my goodness.
You know, but that was my reality, you know. Yeah. And I really connected to these things more than I connected to human beings.
Mm.
You know, so my connectivity to human nature began probably, I would say, like around 10, 11, 12 years of age.
Yeah.
You know, I began to really, you know, develop a pretty strong circle of friends, which I still have to this day.
Yes.
And they were the ones, you know, who just said, man, you're getting too big to, you know, climb trees and catch cicadas. You know, here's a basketball, man. Let's go play some hoops, man. You know, so, you know, that was the shift.
Mm.
But as when I became probably, I'd say around 18, 19 years of age, I really began to read a lot of metaphysical text.
Right.
And I began to study metaphysics and the impact that metaphysics had on this realm, you know, that we identify as our current reality. And so when I began to do that, I began to notice that whenever and whatever I needed to keep me on the path, to keep me focused and aligned, it would be presented.
Mm.
And I acknowledged that there was an unseen presence that was making that happen, which really made getting and being on the path that much more profound an experience for me.
Wow. Wow. That's so beautiful. And so from there, you just embraced it and continued on. Could you see yourself? I don't think in any of our shows we've ever done together, I don't think I've ever asked you that question. But did you see yourself doing what you're doing now? Could you see that?
I couldn't see that specifically, but I knew that there was a path that was opening, a doorway that was opening, a portal, if you will, that was opening, that was going to lead me into, you know, working with individuals and various capacities.
Mm-hmm.
And that's pretty much, you know, how it began. You know, I mean,
right.
We ran the first, you know, African American Yoga Center in Washington, D.C., you know, Anand Ashanti.
Mm-hmm.
And people came from all over the city, you know, to participate in the programs, you know, that we offered. So yoga became, you know, a very, you know, focused path of mine for, you know, a pretty good period of years.
Yes.
And then, you know, I studied with, you know, herbologists. I
yes.
studied with a couple of herbologists who really, you know, taught me the science and the craft, you know, of dealing with herbal medicine.
Mm-hmm.
And then I worked in an herbal pharmacy, you know, for quite some time, and that got me into nutrition and diet and such. So my path has been like an ever-present, ongoing, evolving experience of just opening, you know, from one particular platform into another that eventually took me into energy medicine.
Got it. So how did yoga change your life? I heard you talk about that and having one of the first studios in Chicago. How did yoga change your life? What sort of got you into yoga, and what did it do for you?
Well, yoga as it was practiced back in my day was very different. You know, asana, you know, the different postures, you know, we mastered them. We
That's
did.
Right.
We mastered them. But the only reason that we did them was for the focus and purpose of activation of Kundalini.
Mm.
That was it.
That was it.
Kundalini was what we were really focused on. And the asana, you know, was just a means and method of really preparing and conditioning the human body so that when that energy began to move
through
up and out, that no damage would be done.
Yes.
And that's really the purpose, you know, of
yeah.
asana.
Mm-hmm.
And then we had the pranayama doing the breathing exercises.
Right.
We lived that whole eight limbs. You know, we lived it every single day. You know, and that's one of the things. So when I look around today at yoga institutes or schools and individuals, teachers, you
right.
know, that instruct in the yoga science, it's all about one thing. It's become very one-dimensional. And that mm-hmm. one-dimensional expression, you know, is the asana, and it doesn't really go beyond that.
Mm-hmm.
Yusir Rahotep is probably...
Yes.
the only individual that I know who really combines the breath with the postures to really give a more dynamic, energetic outpouring that you get when you move from one posture into another.
Yeah, and shouts out to Brother Yusir Hotep, Siba Yusir Hotep. Shouts out to that brother too. Wow, that is so, so powerful. Do you... meditate?
Oh, definitely every day.
Mm-hmm. And what did meditation do for you? And what was it like? What is it like for you? Because what I see, I want to hear your take. Yeah, I'm listening. I'm sorry.
For me, this meditation moves me into a place that is beyond time and space.
Mm-hmm.
And it allows my consciousness to move into much deeper places and experience totally different, I don't even know how you can like really frame it, but
right.
experience totally different states of awareness
yes.
that pull in information from higher spheres
yes.
that allow me to really, really get a much deeper control of how I need to navigate my life and
yes.
create in my life.
Yes. And I mean, what do you feel about meditation for calming the mind, helping with anxiety, to learn how to relax?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know, I mean, one of the beautiful things about living in this particular day and time is that you have so many types of guided meditations
right.
that you can use
the spirit
that
quest,
are either spoken and the words very lightly carry you across certain tonal frequencies,
right.
or you can just deal with tonal frequencies that are designed, you know, somatically to activate DNA or to move
yes.
the mind into places where, you know, you can have chakra
That's
activation,
right.
or you can go into actually healing different areas in the body by directing
yes.
intention
mm-hmm.
and following the tones that are guiding you, you know, through the CD that you're listening to.
Yeah.
You know, so, yeah, we have so many tools
yes.
now at our disposal that we can use to really shift us much more rapidly into
yes.
places where we can gain greater access over who and what we are and how we can use that to manifest levels of self-empowerment.
Yes, so powerful. I love it. And this is why I love doing this spirit quest as well. Everyone, we're listening to Dr. Wayne Chandler. I know he don't like when I call him doctor, but he is a doctor. Our brother, Wayne Chandler. And I want to talk about now, because you have something so exciting going on. You do retreats and you take people out into nature. I was just listening to some research on the news that they were talking about something that we've known for a long time and that obviously you've been connected to, is that just seeing something green from nature, how it affects the body on a subatomical level. Like, it's so much healthier
mm-hmm.
for you to be outside, or even if you're working in an office or in a building, if you just open the blinds and look outside and see nature or have a plant next to you. My mother always told me, have more than just yourself living in the space you're in. Have a plant, have these things of nature around you, or go outside, spend time in nature. But you do these very exotic retreats where you've taken people all over the world, and you actually have an event that's coming up very soon, Qigong of Inner Empowerment, and it's going on in Jamaica, August the 11th. Through August 17, 2019, which is coming up, but it's still room for people to get involved. You want to talk to us about this retreat that you're having? Look at all our Jamaica people jumping up. That's right. No excuses. Brother Wayne Chandler is going to be in Jamaica.
My retreats are tailored to the times. And right now, my focus in the retreat is about approaching, developing, manifesting a sense of holism, you know, within the being. And that means learning how to do internal practice, but also creating a integration, a conscious integration with the alignment of cosmic frequency and how that feels, you know, as it moves through you and what it is designed to do. My retreats, because they are focused on the times that we are moving into, you know, I have elements within the design of the retreat that probably a lot of retreats like this would not really have. And those are things like, you know, we have a segment where we talk about investments. And,
beautiful.
You know, what is good, you know, to look at in terms of bona fide, authentic investments that individuals can make once they get back in the world that are going to create financial abundance. Because for me, the base platform has to be the internal spiritual and energetic cultivation of an individual.
Yes.
For material abundance to really, really thrive and work.
That's right. And they go hand in hand. Because if you're broke,
they go hand in hand.
It's going to be hard to practice spiritually. Because if you're practicing spiritually, you won't be broke. Wealth and health.
Exactly. Exactly. So I combined those two dynamics in my retreat and allow, you know, like on this particular retreat, I actually have a brother who's going to be there who's an options trader. You know, he does options in the stock market, you know. So, you know, I've invested, you know, substantially in the stock market, but, you know, I don't do options, you know, and I take my hat off to those people that do options. But we are working, you know, with concepts in cryptocurrencies right now. We have directions, you know, that we can direct people into, you know, that are going to be, you know, really, really advantageous and, you know, fortuitous.
Wow. So you're going to kind of get a conglomerate of understanding about investment and how to invest in yourself once you put those other components. What else could they experience or people expect to experience when they go on this retreat?
What they learn and what they experience, I mean, just the first day, they will have been shifted into a totally different state of reality and awareness. Just the first day.
Wow.
Just the things that I take them through with respect to what it means and showing them how their thoughts create their realities and actually having them experience that. Getting them in touch with the fact that this reality that we live in is a hologram and therefore is subject to manipulation via spiritual intention.
Indeed.
And when you step into those places, you can begin to now design, repattern, and then redesign, if you wish, your realities and how that's done. You know, we talk about and develop and activate, you know, the powers within the circuitry, you know, the internal circuitry, you know, the anatomy, you know, the internal anatomy, energy based, energetically based anatomy, you know, of each participant. So the focus of my retreats is to move people into their fourth dimensional self. That's it. You know,
powerful.
And within that fourth dimensional self, that framework is the experience of total self-empowerment, the development of personal power, so that when you step back into the world, as the saying goes, the world becomes your oyster. You know, you're not doing the song and dance. You've learned how now to have options that you can utilize to help break free from the humdrum, everyday, you know, dog-eat-dog reality that most people have succumbed to and feel is all a part of life.
Absolutely.
The times that we're moving into right now are very, very intense, and we haven't even really stepped through the door yet.
That's true. And so many people are at our door at this time, coming in and out. Dr. Wayne Chandler, you guys, if you're interested to find out more information about this upcoming retreat that's going to be going on in the month of August in Jamaica, you can reach Brother Wayne Chandler at Wayne W. W-A-Y-N-E-B, as in blue, Chandler, C-H-A-N-D-L-E-R at gmail.com, or you can go to waynebchandler.com, and you can get the details and find out about it. So who, Brother Wayne, is this retreat for? Who is it for?
It's for everybody. Mm-hmm. It's for everybody. I mean, I love working with people, you know, who, because when you do internal practices, and doing internal work is very different. It's very different than just like doing yoga.
Yes, it is.
It's not the same.
Right.
And like a lot of your seer students, you know, have crossed over and become my students, you know, and about three of them.
And there's so many different modalities that we can learn. We can learn from so many different perspectives and angles. I think that's what makes it so powerful for this. I have a question once you finish. Somebody has a question, but go ahead. Yes. So the retreat is for anyone.
So it's for everybody. It's for everybody because, you know, what they learn is how to shift, change, and recreate their realities, how to utilize the power that they have cultivated, you know, during the course of the retreat. There's a sister, Nicole Jackson, who is going to be working with me on the retreat, and she's going to be teaching the female practices to the women with respect, because women have their own specific practices
that they themselves
need to learn with respect to self-cultivation. So she's going to be working with them with respect to that.
Beautiful. So let me ask you, the question comes from the chat room from Holistic Hadi. Says, can you be pregnant at the retreat? She wants to know.
Oh, sure. Of course.
Let me make sure I read it right. She didn't say, can you get pregnant? No, she said, can you be pregnant? Okay. You know what? Can you be pregnant at the retreat? Okay. Yes, you can. Oh, my goodness. So, you guys, definitely everything is available in the show notes. Definitely want you to reach out to Brother Wayne Chandler to do that. I know we're going to do an activation here, but I kind of want to see if you guys have questions. Star 6 and press 1. If you guys have a question and you want to come on and you want to ask Brother Wayne Chandler while you have him on the line, and if it's okay with you, we'll kind of open up the phone lines. We'll talk a little bit more, but see if there's some questions out there. You guys got some energy questions you want to ask Brother Wayne Chandler. If you want to ask some more questions, come on the line and we'll take some questions. Otherwise, you know, we will keep going because we are so blessed to have Brother Wayne Chandler come on the line. Like, he literally is an icon living. He's an icon living. And so we're going to come on. So you can ask those questions when it comes to Qigong. You want to know about your energy practice. If you want to put it this way, whatever you want to ask, ask him. He can answer it. He can even do readings because he's done it live here before. So anything you want to ask him, just come on and ask him. All right. We're going to jump around. We're going to go to the callers on the phone. Let's go to 5406. 5406, you're live on Planet Remix. Please tell us who you are and where you're calling from. Going once, 5406. Going twice. Gone. We're going to go to the next caller. Calling in from area code 2159. 2159, you're live on Planet Remix. Please tell us who you are and where you're calling from.
Hi. Hi, this is Victor calling from Philadelphia.
Okay, greetings to you, Victor. Can you take us off speakerphone, please? We're getting it.
Oh, yes, sorry.
That's okay.
Sorry about that. Hey, what's going on? Hey, Brother Chandler. Hi, Ms.Blue.
Hi, how are you, Victor?
How are you?
I'm good. It's been a while since I spoke to both of you guys. I believe last time I spoke to you, Brother Chandler, was probably in like 2011. You did an event here in Philly where you taught your six healing sounds and kidney packing, and that was amazing. It's definitely life changing information. Trying to think questions. I do have a question about the retreat. You said it's coming up August 11th, and that's kind of like, I've been wanting to go to one of your retreats in Jamaica for the longest time. Do you do anything in the States, and how soon would that be coming
up? I really don't do a lot in the States. I'll do a lecture or maybe a workshop here and there in the States. Things that I organize myself, I like to do outside of the States. So, you know, my focus has been, you know, like the UK, Costa Rica, Jamaica, Puerto Rico, you know, places that people can kind of gather a different type and different quality from the retreat outside of just the practices, but just being in a different environment and how that impacts them, especially when you go into places where there's a lot of green, you know.
Right.
As we were talking about earlier.
Right. But just talking to you now, I'm remembering to do Kachari Mudra. I've kind of gotten away from the practices. There was a point like not after I had met with you that I was doing it every day, and I was definitely living a more active lifestyle. But
yeah, you know, I mean, that I think that's one of the hardest things is really staying locked in and staying focused long enough so that it becomes integrated, you know, just into your general matrix. And for you not to do it is something that makes you feel uncomfortable, you know. So if I run across a time frame where, for whatever reason, I'm not doing my practice, I feel so uncomfortable,
right,
that I know I'm going to get back to doing my practice. There's
that's
no
right.
question in my mind that I'm not going to get back there because I feel so discombobulated and out of, synchronicity with everything, not doing it, you know. So a lot of it, the key is being able to be in that length of time so that it really kind of becomes integrated, becomes, you know, like one with who and what you are, so that when you have those spaces or times where you can't get to it, you know that you're going to come back and reconnect.
Right.
So come on retreat.
Mm-hmm.
I will definitely make an effort.
Oh,
definitely.
Yeah, that would be great. Well, thank you for calling in, Victor.
Absolutely. Thanks, Ms. Blue.
You're welcome. Peace and love. Hold the line. Let's go to the next caller. Calling in from area code 5406. 5406, you're live on Planet Remix. Please tell us who you are and where you're calling from. 5406.
Yeah, their phone is kind of acting up. Let's go to 5408.
Hello?
Yes, hello. Greetings, who's on the line?
This is No Thang, calling out of Roanoke, Virginia.
Greetings, No Thang. You hesitated like you didn't know who you were. How are you?
I'm doing well. Because I thought the caller before was
you thought it was you. Oh, 5406. Yeah. Because you got but you're not. Your number's not 5406.
The area code is 540.
Okay.
Yeah, it starts with 540. Yeah.
Okay, that's all right. All right. Yeah. You want to say greetings to Brother Wayne Chandler?
Yes. Greetings, Brother Wayne Chandler.
You don't have to say exactly that. You can say greetings, Brother Wayne.
Okay. Yeah, I'm a student of Yusir and Baba Kwesi. And
Okay, beautiful.
Yeah, and I've been following you for a while too, and I always was inspired by your work. And especially the internal work you do, you're definitely like a model that I strive to become. I have two questions. The first question is, the language that you've been using, dealing with the 1328 and the 1320 frequency, I resonate with that. And I was introduced to that information by Juanique Shabazz and the work of Jose Anguelas. So my question to you is, do you study that, his information, and what is your thoughts? Because since I've been studying it, it's definitely been helping me get a better understanding of my connection on Earth and my cosmic connection.
So this is the thing. I've worked with Jose Aguelos. I began dealing with his work. I believe it was his first book. It was called Earth Ascending, and that was back in the 70s. So the piece is, and this is the catch. So Jose, his focus is trying to get people to revert back to a 13-month, 28-day calendar, but in real time, that's very difficult to do because all of what is around you is always pulling at you to distract and move you back into this three-dimensional 1260 construct of time. So you develop an intellectual knowing and understanding of the process and the importance of frequency and placement and alignment. But then it's about, well, how do you make the jump into really creating the internal environment that Jose Aguelos is speaking on that the 1328 creates for humanity in terms of a fourth dimensional construct? And that can only come through doing the practices, because everything else is there's too much pull, too much wear and tear. There are too many distractions that are being thrown at you. Whereas when you have an internal practice and you're dealing with the philosophical and scientific constructs and information that Jose has created for you to follow, then, you know, as they say, you have your cake and you can eat it too. You know, so the key is definitely, you know, like having a practice, an internal practice that aligns you with the 1328 dynamics, you know, of Jose.
And my second question is, and I appreciate that response. My second question is, you were about to build on the difference between yoga and internal work. Studying Yusir's form of yoga is definitely, the Kemetic yoga is definitely, and what Baba Kwesi came up with, the Osirian tantric yoga it definitely gave me a different understanding of yoga from a melanated perspective. But I wanted to hear your thoughts when you was talking about the difference between yoga and the internal work that you're talking about.
Yeah, I mean, I work with you, Seer, and it's just with the science, the internal science that I work with, you know, it deals with a totally different, you know, anatomical design with respect to energy anatomy. And so it's really about the focus. It's really about going in and activating, you know, those meridians, the nadis. It's about activation of the chakras and those chakra points to the point where you feel those things being activated and the portals being opened. And you are able to take energy and move it through one part of your body into another.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Ashe. I appreciate that, brother.
Yeah, that's
and
beautiful.
Thank you for your time, and thank you, Ms. Blue.
You're welcome.
Oh, yeah, thank you.
Much love to you and the family. Wow, that is some really good stuff. And so, excellent question, Brother No Thang brought up, because it's like we have so many different disciplines that we can really get a chance to look at it from so many different angles and merge them all together, you know? I think it's all about that as above, so below, as without, so within. That sort of kind of brings things together. Really good question. We're going to go to the next caller. I believe is an international caller. Let's see, from a private number. Peace and greetings. Who's on the line, please? Private number. Going once.
Hello?
Oh, yeah, there you go, because you almost got that button. Who's on the line, please?
My name is Irisha. Calling from Iowa.
Okay, greetings. Say your name one more time.
Irisha.
Irisha. Greetings, Irisha. You're calling from Iowa. How's the weather in Iowa?
It's pretty good.
Yeah.
It's been hot.
It's hot
cold,
there,
rainy.
Too.
It just switches up.
All right. Well, good to hear you on the line. You want to say hello to Brother Wayne Chandler?
Oh, hello, Brother Wayne.
How are you doing,
Irisha? I'm good.
Awesome.
I'm a little nervous. Sorry.
That's okay, and for very good reason, I might add. But what's your question?
No, there's no good reason to be nervous.
You can feel the power. You can feel it. What's
yeah.
No, I'm
teasing
you.
It was unexpected that I got through, so I'm like feeling happy, joyful,
aww,
and nervous
beautiful.
At the same time.
Yeah. Well, you're on the line.
Well, I wanted to ask about how many guardian angels do I have?
And I'm going to let Brother Wayne Chandler answer that.
How many guardian angels do you have?
Yeah. Like, do I have relatives that's, like, watching over me?
Well, you definitely have guides, you know, and different individuals depending on who they are and what they're doing in the world and what their design, you know, to do regarding purpose. A lot of times depends on the number of guides that you have at any one time, you know, moving with you. You know, for me, like I've got, you know, 8, 9 guides that move in and out and rotate with me periodically because, you know, I'm usually doing something reckless that I need them to pull me out and save me, you know. But,
you know what?
You know, yeah, you definitely, you have guides, you know, especially that you can even ask that question is saying that there's something in another aspect, a more subtle region of your unconscious that's letting you sense that there are other entities around you that are there protecting you, guiding you, giving you insight in terms of your daily, you know, involvement.
See, I told y'all Brother Wayne Chandler could do it all. See, y'all didn't believe me. There you go. And I didn't mean to put you on the spot, Brother Wayne Chandler, but yeah, definitely. So you have your spirit guides that are there for you as well, too. And of course, you have your ancestors. They're always around us. We always have access to those who are connected to us, you know, that are there. If you want to know what I'm picking up from you right now of how many spirit guides that you have a total of 9 spirit guides. And of those spirit guides, 4 of them are men and 4 of them are women, which is a really, really balanced number when it comes to just masculine and feminine energy and reincarnation and all that good stuff. And one of them is something else. All right. And we'll talk about that. But your guides are there. Remember, they are activated. They're just like having sort of a superhero, like having a hype group with you. If you want to connect with your guides, you can just reach out to them just like we reach out to our ancestors, call their names to speak with them. You know, and right now, the main thing I see for you that your guides are really assisting you with, it has to do with your home. So I know that either you just recently moved or you're thinking about moving, but there is something dealing with your sacred space of where you're living that you're making some decisions on. Is that correct?
Yeah.
Wow. Oh, wow. There we go. Imagine that. So there you go. So your guides are there to really help you. Your guides are there to help you with this decision about you moving. And one of the things I want you to really just be mindful of when you're getting ready to take this move, that you're not just doing this based on, what could I say? So your other spirit guide is not a guide. It's actually a spirit animal, which is a hyena. And I know the Lion King is out, and shouts out to Beyonce and the whole crew and everybody in the Lion King. But you know, the hyenas play a very, very significant role in the Lion King. And in a sense, they sort of are like bullies in one aspect, and they also are like gossipers, and they're kind of like hecklers, you know, and they have some great qualities about them as well. But this is really, the hyenas are actually an opportunity for you to learn how to stand up for yourself even more. That's pretty much, you know, what we've been talking about tonight, about that inner power. And you've got to really sort of kind of stand up for yourself a little bit, and don't let anyone bully you into moving into a particular place, or kind of bully you or sort of back you up into the corner. You know how they did Simba. I feel like the hyenas are just out there trying to back you up into the corner and force you to do something that you don't want to do. So this is time for you to really tap into that energy and take a look at the hyenas, because they really speak to learning how to stand up for yourself and to tap into your own inner power and make your own decision. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing right now. My throat is even like scratchy talking about it. Like, I'm really fighting. I'm trying my hardest to, like, do it without being, how can I say, mean or come off a certain way. You know, I had to, So just trying to.
Yeah. Well, here's the thing. Nothing helps better than to get our thoughts on a piece of paper, right? Because spirit moves on written words. And some of the best meditations we can do in concentration is to get out a piece of paper and a pen and start to write. But don't be distracted. You know, Brother Wayne Chandler has been talking about the outside world so much here, learning how to navigate 3D world, 4D world. Right now, you're letting this 3D world make a decision for your 4D self. And you don't want to do that because you got to live with you.
Mm-hmm.
So take your time, weigh your options. Don't feel like someone's pressuring you, bullying you to do it either way. And make sure that you are making a conscious decision that's in your highest good. Ask your guides, ask your ancestors. They can show up in dreams and to send you signs. Yeah, you got it though. There you go.
Thank you.
You're so
welcome.
I appreciate
that.
You're welcome. And welcome to Planet Remix. You got 2 for 1 on a good call night. So hold the line.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Peace and love. Mm-hmm. All
right. Peace and love.
Yeah, beautiful. Let's go to the next caller. Calling in from area code 9193. 9193, you're live on Planet Remix. Please tell us who you are and where you're calling from.
Hello.
Yes, hello. Greetings, who's on the line?
Hi, Ms.Blue. This is Janae.
Hi, Janae. Yeah, you were in the chat.
Hi, I'm calling from Raleigh, North Carolina. And also, hi, Brother Wayne. How you doing?
I'm doing well.
Okay, so I just wanted to ask about comedic yoga. Like, I mean, I know it seems obvious, but what are the differences between comedic yoga and, like, you know, average yoga that we always hear about?
Comedic yoga, for one thing, you know, it has a history that's locked in ancient Kemet or Egypt. And so the postures that are done are reflective, you know, of very specific postures found in ancient Kemet. And they're not as I guess you would say reflective of the postures, you know, that are practiced in your East Indian systems.
Okay.
The way your seer and Kwesi, the way they instruct and teach the comedic tradition in the yoga, they really, really focus a lot on breath, and they use what's called Kachari Mudra, which is tongue connection. And when you use the tongue connection, there are certain placements or points along the roof of the mouth that when you mm-hmm. take the very tip of the tongue and place them along one of those three points,
yes.
you generate a very specific frequency or current of energy through the body. And so when you move into specific postures and you're doing the breath work along with the Kachari Mudra, the tongue connection, it generates a different experience between one posture and another.
Okay, so that would be like when Dr. Aline Bay, he talks about when you put your tongue into your mouth and you like, or you say little chants like so and things like that.
Yeah, he's also talking about the Kachari Mudra.
Okay. Can I ask one more question? I don't know, like, it doesn't matter. I guess whoever can answer.
Go ahead.
Okay.
Of course he can.
Okay, so thank you. I feel like I'm right on time, like, in my own life, because I just started looking up yoga 2 days ago, and I did my first practice all by myself the other day. But anyway, on to my question. Okay, so I look up different quizzes about my chakras, because I feel like, okay, maybe my throat chakra is a little too active, but I don't know how accurate those quizzes are. So can you go in and see, you know, what it's looking like so I can, you know, fix myself?
You know what, Brother Wayne?
I mean, it doesn't matter. I know Ms. Blue is like, you know, she might pass you to me. I mean, pass me to you. So either way, I know I'm, you know, it's all good.
It's up to you, Brother Wayne. If you want to answer, if you want me to do it, I it's up to you.
What was I did? I really didn't catch the end of the question. What was the? I know the question was about your throat chakra, but what is it that you're trying to?
I'm sorry. That one of like I took a little quiz about chakras, and they asked you a series of questions. So it looked like my crown chakra was like 56, and the third eye was like in the 50s, and the throat chakra was somewhere, but the rest of them were all the way down. My heart chakra is still like 12%, and I'm like, ooh.
So let me jump in really quick because I kind of got the question, but I want to say this to you: if you took a quiz, right?
Yeah.
And it told you that all these things were closed. Did it tell you how to fix it?
No, see, well, it didn't exactly say they were closed. It just was giving me percentages of, like, how open they were.
Did it tell you how to open it?
It said things like different colors.
Hold on. Yes or no?
Well, yeah.
Did it tell you?
Yes.
Did you do it? Did you do it?
Yes and no, not to the effect, but I just wanted to, confirm.
Hold on a second. I want you to stay here because I want you to see something because tonight is about inner power. So,
okay.
Did you do it? Did you do what it said?
I'm a no. I'm going to say no because I didn't really go all the way in.
Okay. Mm-mm. And so why not?
Only I've done it. I guess because I didn't really trust the quiz.
Okay, so stop right there. Stop right there. So if you didn't trust the quiz, why are you trusting it now?
I guess, no, I don't trust it. That's why I'm trying to ask. I'm trying to ask for help, like, because I know when you call in, sometimes you can get in and see if somebody...
Yeah.
What they can do as far as their chakra work, you know?
Yeah, no, it's fine. So,
your throat chakra is strong. I mean, you have a strong throat chakra. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's not, you know, it has the energy around and within it is very vibrant and dense. So, you know, I'm not picking up anything that's a defective or deficient in your throat.
I don't see anything physically, but emotionally, I do.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah, so maybe I should have rephrased the question or been more specific.
No. I think you did a great job of really with the question. You really did. I think energetically, you are projecting the front of your throat chakra is very strong, but your internal communication... Because we understand what you're saying, but you are not clear with you. And that's really all I care about, is that you're clear with you. You get it? We want you to be clear and confident enough with you. And that's what the work is about. The work that Brother Wayne Chandler does, what this retreat is about, it's about learning how to go within so that you can be clear enough with you. So what I see is that your front of your throat chakra looks beautiful, vibrant, which means that you are communicating your thoughts, you're expressing yourself, and you're very good with communicating outside of you. But when it comes to you talking to you, that communication is shaky. That's where the work needs to be. Yeah. Internal. It needs to be more internal. Yeah. So it's nothing wrong with, it's a lot of great information that's out there, and it's nothing wrong with doing those quizzes and tests, but also you doing the work would have told you whether or not that was a good measure for you. So I was just curious as to why you didn't do the suggestions.
Well, I said no because I did focus on, like, one of the things that my sacral chakra was low, so I was like, okay, I'm going to get out an orange candle and look at it. But then other than that, I just been, meditating for maybe 30 minutes or an hour. Like, I'll cut everything off and just let my brain flow. But that's about the only thing tangible that I've really been doing.
Right.
You know, so I was just like, what else can I, you know, do? Because I be talking about the fourth dimension all the time. And, you know, when you keep hearing about things, it's like, not a coincidence. This is stuff that I want to work on. So, yeah.
Well, what do you think about just your sacral chakra? Because in scanning it, it feels weak. I mean,
mm-hmm.
I mean, are you experiencing like issues, or you have challenges in that area?
Mhm.
Yeah, because I'm. Yeah, there, yeah. There's. Yeah, that you have. Yeah, you have challenges there for sure.
Yeah.
Yes, and like it's like my back. You know, my back hurts a lot. And I'm just like, okay, so when I started reading about the chakras and how they coincide spiritually, I was just like, okay, well, duh, that's a sign. But I'm like, okay, what else can I do besides, I guess, meditating? Because I can feel the areas, like, but I don't know.
Well, I do a form of energy work, and probably 98% of the work that I do with people is remote, you know. So I use holographic projection, and I've worked with the chakras. It's a form of what's called medical qigong, and it deals with the spiritual, emotional, mental, and physical aspects, you know, of which all the chakras have their, you know, affiliations to. So, you know, if you want to do deeper work, you know, I mean,
check
out my website.
Yeah, go to Brother Wayne Chandler's, and I've had a session with Brother Wayne as well. So that's definitely some of the things that you can begin to do. And so all you have to do, go to the website, Wayne B. Chandler, or WayneBChandler@gmail.com, and send an email, read the information on the website, and see what's there. In the meantime, you know, one of the things that I would encourage you to do is, really, I see your diet is playing a bigger role energetically for you as well, too. That can kind of help you stay a little calm.
And, okay.
Yeah, and just relax. I think you're doing way too much, and you're taking in way too much information, and this is just spinning you. You know, it's kind of like a bottle top that's just spinning. And that's, believe it or not, that could sometimes be the worst thing we do. We just get on the internet and we just keep searching and searching and searching. And, you know, just kind of slow yourself down, trust where you are, and start to work from that perspective, you know? Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. I'm really, because the diet thing you just mentioned, a lot of people, and I'm going to be honest, because, you know, you get a lot of information on the internet, a lot of people, spiritual counselors, and they say that health, that what you eat has nothing to do with you spiritually. So I'm glad that this has kind of confirmed what
was already in my mind. Well, I'm one of those people that say that. But here's the thing. You have to be in a certain frequency. If you're in a certain frequency, you can overcome anything. But it can also send you in the other way if certain things are not in alignment. Right?
Right.
So what you're going to do if you're stranded on an island and you don't have any food to eat, you're going to automatically be, no, you have to learn how to transcend, but that takes work. So some things can be taken out of context. And my thing is, if you eat meat or don't eat meat, that doesn't determine how spiritual you are. I know some people like to think it does, but it doesn't. And we're all different. And you may can eat meat, and someone else may can't eat meat. It just not be agreeable with their blueprint. So the whole goal is to get to know you uniquely so you can understand yourself and everything around you.
Okay. Cool. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, I'm one You're of welcome. The people who say that.
Okay, yeah, because I never heard you personally, never heard you say that, but it's just like, yeah, you kind of got to get up there first, climb the ladder before you can just be like, oh, I can do what I want.
Yeah. You know, you just got to know yourself. Yeah. Some people can't eat strawberries, mm-hmm. and we ain't mad at them.
Mm. Okay. Well, right. Thank you again. Thank
You're
you again.
Welcome. Peace okay. and love. Thanks for calling in, Janine. Great question. Great question. Janine says she want to know. I love it. Absolutely. Let's go to the next caller calling in from area code 4092. 4092, you're live on Planet Remix. Who's on the line?
Hello.
Hello. Greetings. Who's on the line, please? And where you're calling from?
Yes, this is Tirza calling from Beaumont, Texas.
Okay, I'm sorry. I couldn't hear you. Can you speak up a little bit? Ooh.
Sorry.
That's okay. Just
moving into a corner of the house so I wouldn't wake everybody up.
Okay, that's fine.
Hello, Brother Wayne. It's Ms. Blue.
Mm-hmm. Greetings.
Hello, how are you?
I'm well. You remind me, you have like this feel of my grandfather. He was a professor and just... You just have this vibe of him, and I appreciate and everything that you gave to me today that I received just confirmed a lot of things that I've been working on and going back and listening to things that Ms. Blue has helped me with as far as, like, my overall being and everything that's led up to me now. And where I'm going, you know, I feel like I'm already in certain places and where I was all in this very moment. I feel like all of that is happening, has happened, and still here, if that makes sense to you all. But I've been trying to get back to feeling myself and, you know, healing myself and, you know, just genuinely looking at my family and my surroundings and taking it in for what it is and, you know, trying to manipulate that. Like, if they say you can heal generational curses and stuff, I feel like then if I'm that one to see something and I know I'm not crazy, then I can somehow manipulate that. And so I've been quieting myself, like, whenever I go work out, I feel like I'm getting more consistent with that, even though it hasn't been that long, and juicing and doing things to clear my mind and clear my way for me. And I've done, like, practices in the mirror with a candle, and I just was repeating, healing my family, healing myself. And then later that day, my mom told me she woke up from a dream crying about someone telling her when her mother died. And to me, that was confirmation that I can do that, that's possible. And if the all is mental, then all I have to do is clear my mind to make that way.
Yeah, I mean, you feel like you're definitely on a journey, you know, and there are a lot of moving parts, you know, to that. I feel there's a lightness of being because you're opening and exploring new avenues of how you express your deeper levels of creativity. And with that, you know, there's also there are elements of heaviness and challenge there as well, you know, that rear their presence and, you know, kind of get in the way at times, and that makes you feel a little heavy at times.
Yeah, and you know, the main thing is we have to remember to love ourselves through the process, you know. through the process of all that we're learning, that we're discovering, that we're experiencing, and truly know we are a work in progress. I think sometimes the expectation is that we're going to get to a point and everything is going to be wonderful. and nothing will ever happen that will cause our emotion to ever dip, dive, crash, or fall. And that's really not the role that our emotions play in our life. But it is about understanding about chi, about life force energy, because it is meant to flow through us. So that same energy that causes the clouds to sort of float across the sky and the tree limbs to fly, you have to allow things to be able to flow through you. And when you start on that path of, you know, the best way to really dive into those things that we call ancestral curses or whatever we want to call them, is to really do the work on ourselves. Because by healing us, that does so much for those who came before us and those that will come after us and those that are here and our world. To have that love, lead with love, to put love in the forefront, you know? So it's powerful what you're doing because you're leading with love. And love will find a way. Doesn't mean necessarily the physical love. Love will find a way means it will help lead you to your next step and your next step and your next step and your next step. Lead with love. And start with the love of yourself, you know? Yeah, don't be so hard on yourself. You're doing an amazing job. You have a question for Brother Wayne Chandler?
I do.
Okay.
Oh, well, possibly. I have a question, yes. My son, he's 4. He's going to start school, and he's never been anywhere for school or daycare or anything. And how can I prepare for that? I just feel dumbfounded, kind of skeptical, and I guess that's a part of the process, but how can I prepare that for all of us? I just feel clueless, even though I've been to school. Mm-hmm.
Well, if you're choosing to send your child to school, the first thing I will say is be involved. My children growing up, I didn't send them nowhere that I didn't check out first. Be involved. Know where you're sending him, what he's going to be doing, what's going to happen. Be involved.
And listen to everything that is being said by him.
That's
right. As he encounters these experiences.
Yep. First step, definitely. Okay. Know where you're sending him. Because how you to mama and you scared? Guess what he's going to be?
I feel like I've made a good decision, but I just keep playing in my mind that I won't be able to be there all day.
And you won't.
And it's kind of good that I feel that this opportunity is opening up for me because I want to start catering and building my business.
Beautiful.
And I still have my youngest son with me, but I just feel like
you don't want to let go.
That's it. You got the problem.
You don't.
We need to be talking to him so he can calm you down. But you know, really, I think a lot of that.
That boy is an old man.
Yeah, a lot of it is a natural parent mother instinct. But what curbs all of that, believe you, I get it, is to be aware. Go there and make sure you understand where he's going to be, where the classroom is going to be, who's he going to be interacting. You get to ask all these questions for a place that you're leaving your child.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's all going to be fine.
That's right.
It really is.
Trust me. He's going to have fun with kids his age, playing and doing what kids do.
He's got a good internal matrix. He's a strong little brother.
He is.
Yeah, I can feel it. I can feel his energy.
Yeah, we might
what
need
about
to get,
my youngest?
Get him on the phone.
You don't wake up that renegade.
That's beautiful. Mm-hmm.
Thank you all so much.
You're welcome. Well, you
have
are
a great rest of the night.
Yeah, you're an amazing mom. Mm-hmm. Have fun, and you know, all is well. And you remember, children also can read energy probably better than we can and faster. So, you know, make sure you keep that in mind as well, too, for both of those two little warriors. All right. Peace and love. Hold the line. All right. We're going to go to the next caller calling in from area code 9174. 9174, you're live on Planet Remix. Please tell us who you are and where you're calling from.
Greetings, this is Key from Jersey.
Okay, greetings to you, Key from Jersey.
Peace and love, Brother Chandler. Ms. Blue.
Peace and love.
All right. So I have a question for you, Brother Chandler. Wondering, what are your ideas about enlightenment? Would you say that they're traditional, like in regards to maybe Buddhist or Hindu ideas of enlightenment? And how do you think, what do you feel like your best advice is? I'm sorry.
To become enlightened?
Yes. How to get there. I'm just curious about your thoughts
hard work.
Yeah, no, I get it.
Consistency, you know. I would ask you, I mean, what is your program? What kind of daily practice do you have currently? Are you Buddhist or are you Hindu, or you know what is what's your path?
I tend to resonate with Vajrayana Buddhism, which is a mixture of Hinduism and Buddhism. I don't practice in entirety per se, because I don't go to a temple, I don't have an enlightened master, you know, like not tradition, but as far as philosophy, that's what resonates with me the most. And it took me a long time to actually come to that realization and put a label on it. But speaking to Ms. Blue, she actually helped me to narrow it down, because it is very important for me in order for me to grow.
No, I'm teasing.
That's interesting. I'm not locked in, you know, and aware of too many sects, but I find that to be very interesting, because Buddhism, in terms of the principles of the Buddha, I would say that they were pretty much diametrically opposed to those of Hindu.
Yeah,
exactly. Because I feel like it's balanced.
You know, so, yeah, I mean, how do you approach this path with specific meditations or practices that you have? Are you taught specific practices?
No, I honestly am like led by my intuition. So I might, you know, and whatever I'm tapped into.
Then the first thing I would suggest is really design a program for yourself, you know, daily practice for yourself, and be consistent, you know, with that. And that can include meditation. It can include emotional clearing, you know, that you can find within the framework of like Qigong, dealing with the organs of the body, and, you know, just really dealing with just kind of clearing your internal network first and foremost, because I feel that in doing that, you're going to get a lot more clarity. You're not really clear about what it is you want to do and how you want to proceed and achieving what you think you want to get out of this. But, you know, you need to work with specific practices that are going to give you a certain degree and level of clarity. And with that will come a lot more focused intent with respect to what it is you want to do and how you want to go about getting there. Right now, enlightenment is a long way off. But you do want to get a solid program. I feel that you have an earnest heart and that you're sincere about developing and expanding yourself. Really moving into more transcendental spheres, but you just need you need some guidance, you know, with how to do that.
Okay. Sounds good. Yeah, I was curious about your perspective because I like to hear about the path of enlightenment from people who are Afrocentric. And you know what I'm saying, and what they think about it, and you know, what wisdom I can gain from their thoughts.
Why do you think I'm Afrocentric?
Just knowing who you came up under, like I believe you said you came up under Henry Clark and Dr. Ben.
No.
Like you studied up under them. No.
No.
We didn't say that.
I never. No.
I'm like, this was the former show.
No, I
could have sworn you said that in a previous show, in the last show that you were on.
No, I've never worked with Dr. Ben, and I've never worked with John Henry Clark.
Okay, so you never like studied up under them at all.
No.
Wow. Apologies. I thought that was you.
I think you. Maybe I think you're talking about Dapper Dan. He said that on the Breakfast Club.
No, I haven't. I haven't even listened to that.
I'm teasing, but he did say that. I don't know. I never heard that.
Oh,
but
okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And those are two extraordinary brothers that put out a wealth of knowledge as well too.
Oh, right. Okay, yeah. So that was my bad. I thought that's
I was trying to figure out where you was going with this, but I said, hey, let me sip on my tea and cross my legs and listen. I was just... No need of me being nosy. I was just listening. That's beautiful, though. But I really thank you for calling in, Keith, for, you know, with your question. And sharing your perspective. I think it's a great question about enlightenment. I actually was pondering it myself. I don't know if I ever internalized it that way. Like, what do I think about enlightenment? Yeah, interesting. But I love it. Thank you so much for calling in. Peace and love to you. Thanks for calling in. Yeah.
Sure. Peace and love to you both. Have a good evening.
You too.
You too.
That was cute. Let's go to the next caller calling in from area code 8606. 8606, you're live on Planet Remix. Please tell us who you are and where you're calling from. 8606, going once. Going twice. We're going to go to the next caller. I think something's wrong with their phone. Let's go to the next caller calling in from area code 5672. 5672, you're live on Planet Remix with Ms. Blue and Dr. Wayne Chandler. Who's on the line, please?
Hello?
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 Yes.
Yes. Yes, who's on the line, please?
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
How you doing?
I'm good. Man, can you take us off speakerphone? You're coming in pretty low.
Well, is that better?
That is better. Who's on the line, please?
Najee.
This is Najee. Where are you calling from, Najee?
Toledo, Ohio.
Okay, you're calling from Ohio. Greetings. You got a question for Brother Wayne Chandler?
Wow, no, this, man, this is amazing. I just wanted to know, man, there's so much I wanted to know. I've been doing this for like probably about a year, like meditating and just learning different things. And I just want to know if I'm going on the right path in my life.
Mm-hmm. Well, if we can get your phone right.
Well, you can't go wrong with meditation.
Okay, I'll be quiet. Go ahead, brother.
I'm sorry.
I was going to say, if you don't get your phone right, your path is going to come to a halt because we can't hear you clear. So whatever you over there doing, we need you to digress and come closer.
Okay.
All right.
So what else does your path encompass, you know? So you're doing meditation. What other types of practices, you know, and projects are you working with?
Just like manifesting, trying to get out of the situation that I'm in now, just trying to make a better life for myself and my family.
Okay. So you're practicing meditation and you're looking for meditation to do exactly what with respect to the current challenges that are at your doorstep? Are you using meditation as like a tool to try to shift your current environment?
Yes, like just make my life more peaceful, make this world just go easier than what it been going for me. Cause I'm 31 now. I mean, I had a pretty cool life. It's just, I know it's more out there for me. And I just
Toledo. You know, I mean, Toledo can be hardcore. I'm in Cleveland, so I know how hardcore Toledo can be. You know, but, you know, what I would say is, you know, it sounds like you're looking to do some training, maybe something to deal with subconscious refinement and cultivation, where you can get a stronger hold on how you want to kind of shift your three-dimensional realities and what exactly that may look like. So, you know, reach out, go to my website, because, you know, I'm not far from you. So, yeah.
Wow. All right. Man, I'll come in and get direction. Thank you.
Oh, you're so
okay,
welcome.
Okay, brother.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I just got one more question. Can y'all tell me about my spirit guide?
that's like my hot topic question, Brother Wayne, in case you didn't know. Everybody wants.
Is it okay?
Yeah,
okay.
It's a hot topic. But you can answer if you want to, Brother Wayne. You want to answer?
No, please. go right in.
Oh, my goodness. All right. So the number of spirit guides that you have is actually you have two spirit guides that are with you. And interesting enough, of your two spirit guides, both of these spirit guides are women. That's interesting. Mm. Two of them are women, right? Of the spirit guides. And let me ask you a question, because your spirit guides, one of them, it was a question a sister asked in the chat room, and now I see this with you. I see one of the spirit guides who's pregnant. Now, in her pregnancy, she's talking about a miscarriage. So tell me what that has to do with you at this time.
Whoa. I don't know, Blue. That's... Wow.
Well, if it's not something... If it's not anything in the physical, because sometimes it can be spirit, it can be from a spiritual aspect. Now, when we talk about miscarriages or something being missed, this has to do with justice in your life. And it could be a miscarriage. So this has to do with future plans or something you're doing that may need to be aborted. So I want you to think about some of the things that you're setting up for yourself to do, and maybe it needs to be aborted, or it may not be fulfilled the way that you're thinking. So I want you to open yourself up a little bit more to the universe and focus on your end goal as opposed to every single step and how you feel it must happen. And that's what you're doing now.
Okay.
And that's a little different than setting an intention. Look at the end, what you want the end result to be, as opposed to how you want it to happen. You may say, I want it to happen on the 3rd, and it needs to happen at 2 o'clock, and I need to be walking down this block. I need to go in this door for it to happen. And the universe may simply say, we need you to be at home and receive a phone call, and it can happen. So don't try... you're focusing too much energy, and it's going to cause a misstep, a miscarriage to happen. So if it's definitely not in the physical, and I'll take your word for it, then this has to do with that, because you have a lot of unresolved emotions that you're putting into this, and it's sending out mixed messages, you know, as opposed to what you want. We know energy goes where thought flows. And you're focusing so much on what you don't want to happen that you're actually creating it. So focus on what you want to happen. Remember, never face a reality you don't want. Focus on what you want and take your action step from there. Work on your issues with your mama too. Do that for me. Please work on those issues with your mama. Do that. Okay?
Okay.
All right. Peace and love.
All right. Thank you. Bye.
Bye. Oh, gosh. Let's go to the next caller calling in. How we doing, Brother Wayne Chandler? We doing all right?
Yeah, we're doing good.
Okay. All right. We're going to go. It's a lot of callers. They all want to speak to you. Let's go to, we're going to try 5406 again. 5406, you're live on Planet Remix.
Hello.
Hello. Greetings. Hello. Who's on the line? Yes. Hello.
Hello. How are you, Ms. Blue?
I'm good. Who's on the line?
This is Naisha from Virginia.
Greetings, Naisha from Virginia. You want to say greetings to Brother Wayne Chandler?
Greetings, greetings. How are you?
I'm doing well, Naisha. I'm doing very well.
Good, good. I really only have one question. I am very new to this, and it's been amazing listening to the shows and learning, as well as getting in tune with myself. I'm on a journey, and I have a lot of things going on, but I would like to know about my spirit guides.
You know what, y'all? Okay. You know what? All right. I guess you want me to do this one, Brother? Y'all know Brother Wayne Chandler can do this too, right? Don't let him fool you. So when y'all get to Jamaica,
right.
I want that to be the first question. Tell me.
No.
Interesting. Okay, so you have 4 spirit guides that are with you. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 spirit guides that are with you. And, four spirit guides that are with you. Three of them are women and one is a man of your spirit guides. I'm not going to go into all of that there with them. But interesting enough, number one thing that I see is one of them is a, I don't even know what this job title would be, but he made ponds. Man-made ponds, P-O-N-D, ponds, you know, with water, you know, that's in it.
Right.
And one of the things that he had to do when he would set up these ponds for people, he would go around, and particularly it would be people with a lot of land that were farmers, and, you know, they wanted to have this body of water, because water really is a very strong, you know, element. And plus it is what is needed to sustain life that's here on the planet, as we know. But one of the things that he had had to learn a lot about is the ecosystem that went into the pond, and what fish, what allergy, what kind of things he could put inside the water that would keep the pond clear. Because when we talk about water in a pond, we're not talking about flowing water. We're talking about water that stands still. Well, he learned very early on how to make a sprinkler system or a waterfall in the pond, so he could get the energy of the water to move, so that it wouldn't get filled up with allergy and it wouldn't look all murky and dirty and all of this other stuff in the pond. I'm trying to be very quick, but for whatever reason, you got to get this. And so one of the things for you at this time, think about this. The pond represents water, and water is a representation of our emotions and our intuition. And these are the two things that we really need to learn how to balance. I always say intuition before emotions. And right now you're putting your emotions before everything. And that is sort of getting you into troubled waters. This is really what's bringing your emotions in a difficult level. So a lot of the things that Dr. Wayne Chandler is talking about learning how to really get into the internal power, doing it through breath, doing it through meditation, doing it through the mudras, doing it through calming yourself and really just understanding more about who you are, is really the path you need to be on. So I want you to think about the next time your emotions start to lead first. Take a second, take a deep breath, breathe in through your mouth and slow through your nose, drop down in your body and ask yourself the question, what is it that I'm really feeling? Because contrary to popular belief, we do not carry our emotions for ourselves in our heart. We carry that in our solar plexus. And most of the time, we are not connected to the true feelings of what we're feeling. So do that.
Mm-hmm.
Just kind of calm yourself first before you allow your emotions to just run rampant. Because our emotions love to play with our mind.
Right.
And focus on what you want, love yourself through the process, and settle yourself down. So you have four spirit guides that are there. One of them used to build ponds, which is about that. And you're building ponds all over the place, sister. You got ponds everywhere you go. You building you a pond. So just relax, calm yourself, and start focusing, visualizing on your outcome that you want. And then ask yourself the question, how am I really feeling? If the energy is not what you want, you can ask your spirit guides, the ancestors, the angels, to help uplift you to a higher vibration so you can tap into yourself.
Okay.
All right? And if that don't work,
yes, ma'am.
Wiggle your toes and say, I choose to be here. so you can get back inside your body. Because right now, too much of you is outside your body. I mean, we're always kind of out of our body, but you're way out of your body. And you need to ground yourself mentally, physically, and spiritually. So wiggle your toes. Go outside in nature. And focus on goodness. Ground yourself. Intuition first, emotion second. All right?
Yes, ma'am. I understand.
Well, beautiful. Thank you for calling in, and peace and love to you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I want to remind you guys, Dr. Wayne Chandler is doing his retreat. It's going to be in August. You still have plenty of time to get in. If you want to find out about the details, you definitely need to go over to waynebchandler.com and you can get the details there. You can also email Brother Wayne Chandler if you want to find out about one-on-one session or if you want to come to the retreat in Jamaica at Wayne, WayneBChandler@gmail.com. Everything's going to be available in the show notes. We have a few more minutes. We'll see if we can take a couple of more callers. No more spirit guides tonight. I'm going to send them all to bed. I don't care what part of the world you live in. They're going to bed. We're sending all the spirit guides, the ancestors. We're putting them to sleep. And we're going to keep going, and we're going to go to the next caller. Let's go. 7063. 7063, you're live on Planet Remix.
Hey, Ms. Blue.
Hello. Greetings. Who's on the line?
This is Abdul from Georgia.
Okay. Greetings, Abdul from Georgia. What part of Georgia are you calling from?
Fort Oglethorpe.
Okay.
It's north of Atlanta.
Okay.
About an hour or so.
Okay. Greetings. You got a question for Brother Wayne Chandler?
It's kind of with you too, because I remember calling in last week and we were talking about that recalibration of the that throat chakra. I've had a few dreams this past week, and I remember you were telling one sister that called in about when you like in a Well, my dreams basically were, it was kind of like I was at a award show, and it was like I won, like the Oscars, that type of prestige, or Grammys or something like that, to that level. And like consecutive night, maybe two or three nights in a row, I kept, you know, winning whatever prize it was, and I would go up in front of all these people and get ready to make a speech. But I just remember,
beautiful.
It was kind of like, I don't know if it was like an initiation or there's something showing me that I'm being rewarded in the spirit world, but because sometimes, you know, you get into consciousness and sometimes you hit obstacles and you feel like, oh, man, I've been in this for a few years. You think you don't really make that much improvement, but to have a dream like that and to have that reassurance when I wake up, just, you know what, everything's okay. I'm in a good place.
That's
no matter
right.
what's going on physically. You know?
Yeah, that's a beautiful
thing. So I'm starting
thing.
To get to that place.
Yeah.
To not beat myself up.
Yay.
You know,
I don't like beating up. No, don't beat yourself up. Not all the
yeah.
time.
So don't for do a while, it. Actually, since I, for a while, that's kind of how it was. But, you know, in a way, I had to kind of keep stating to myself, I'm in a good place no matter what. So at the end of the day, you know, even when you're going through, you kind of got to smile and know that everything's going to be okay.
That's right.
Because I've read too much, and guys like Wayne Chandler panicking, everybody kind of say, you know, hey, we're going to be all right eventually. So I just kind of, you know, pick myself up doing that. But those dreams I had, those type of dreams since I've been getting into consciousness, those really stuck out to me. I mean, among other dreams, but there's those two to have that type of dream that made me put me in a good place.
And it should. So. It should really put you in a good place. And I think it's a good thing to celebrate along the way and really celebrate our consistency. You know, if we're going to say that we are creating our reality, you know, it was, I don't know if you heard the show last week, but a brother said something so profound. When I asked him how he was doing, he said, I'm trying to be responsible and stable at the same time. And if we could just really tap into being responsible and stable, oh my goodness, your world will change.
Yeah.
So beautiful. So what's your question for Brother Wayne Chandler? Thank you for sharing that. That was powerful.
Yeah. Well, I think I need to kind of, because I don't know. I'm trying to find, like, what kind of practice I need to kind of do, like a daily resonance for energy work for me. Because, you know, I try a lot of things, and some things don't seem like they're working. And I've kind of gotten to a place where, okay, maybe I could try a different approach.
Right.
Because I used to sit up a bunch of altars and this and that. And
well, go to Jamaica. Take a chance on yourself.
Yeah. Now, is that like a couple thing, or just one person? Can I just go individually, or how does
that
actually
work? Look at you.
Look at you. I wasn't listening to the whole
thing. Is this a couple's thing?
Well,
no, it's not a couple's thing, you know.
Well, no. I know it's like energy work, but I meant like, I thought it was like with your partner or something, and I wasn't sure.
No.
Okay. I can use that, something like that.
Yeah, you can come by yourself. It will be like-minded people there.
Okay.
Mhm. All right.
Well, it's me. Well, thank y'all. I appreciate everything. And yeah, peace and love. As
take
you
good
say.
Care.
Peace and love. Keep those dreams a coming.
Yes, hold ma'am. The line. Thank y'all.
Hold the line. Peace and love.
Okay.
All right, we're gonna go to the next caller calling in from area code 7134. 7134, you're live on Planet Remix. Please tell us who you are and where you're calling from.
Hey, what's going on, family? It's Dreamwise.
I'm sorry. Who's on the line, please?
Dreamwise, can you hear me?
I can't.
Let me get off the speaker.
Yeah, okay, because it sounds like you got your phone in your pocket.
Oh, my bad.
And no, I'll leave
Dream
it right
Wise
there. Who's
Houston,
on the line?
Texas.
Who is it?
Dreamwise.
Dreamwise from Houston, Texas.
Oh, okay, thank you, Brother Wayne.
Yes. Can you hear me, Ms. Blue?
I can now. You can put a little bass up in there. You want to be a dream, you
got
to
come
through.
I got some of that. I got some of that Barry White in me, you hear me? For real.
I love the
name,
Dreamwise.
yes, there you go. I appreciate everything you do, Ms. Blue, and I appreciate you, Wayne Chandler. I got one question for Wayne, Brother Wayne.
Mm-hmm.
Can you explain how, in your book, Ancient Future, how... Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay. Can you explain how in your book, the seven hermetic laws, as a magician, they're kind of supposed to be broken, the last six, and how all of that ties into the first law, the mind is all, the universe is mental?
Well, I mean, that's your base, you know. The first axiom, you know, that you know, all is mind, you know, the universe is mental. You know, that holds the secrets, you know, for basically how you create and how you manifest different aspects of your reality. You can use the other laws or some of them, you know, to enhance that, like the law of vibration. You get into determining different patterns and frequency and creating different levels of intention. That intention can be emotional or it can be directly mental.
Excuse me, Brother Wayne Chandler. Can you Dreamwise cut your computer speakers? We're getting feedback, and I want to make sure that everybody can hear Brother Wayne Chandler, because this is such good information. But it's We're getting too much
feedback. Okay, okay.
Yeah, you cut it off? Okay, perfect.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Okay, I'm sorry, Brother Wayne. Go ahead.
Yeah, so the piece with the first axiom is really dealing, in essence, with the nature of our universe, you know, our overall reality, you know, as being holographic. And because it is holographic, you look at, well, what is the one thing that is real in the schematic of all of this that we're engaged in, and that is spirit. You know, so mind, as it was looked upon and embraced in antiquity, mind and spirit are the same thing. They're one and the same. You know, so divine mind is spirit, and spirit is what we use to really shape, recreate, reformat, repattern the realities around us, or the reality that we want to create, because we have an understanding that reality is holographic and that it bends to the shape of our intention or our projected will. And we can use different aspects of the different axioms to embellish or enhance or intensify that, such as, like I said earlier, vibration. You know, so as above, so below.
Yeah, that's important, because what I got from your book is that, while I was reading it and everything, and I love the book, I go to that more than any other book, understanding that these laws can be manipulated and changed according to your will, and you know, basically the mental alchemy that you put upon the other six laws, because the mind is all of the universe's mental.
Exactly, you know, I mean, and that's because it is all holographic, and so, you know, I don't really get into the dynamics of holographic in that particular chapter, you know, so that's in my next book. You know, I'm talking about the nature of that particular axiom, and, you know, it's fundamental design as being one that reflects a holographic reality, and getting into what that really signifies and what that means with respect to spirit and the ability for spirit to project intention to repattern and reshape reality.
Awesome. Thank you, Wayne. Thank you, Ms. Blue, man.
You're welcome. Thank you.
You're very welcome.
Thank you for calling in, Dreamwise. Yeah, thank you for calling in. Yeah, beautiful, beautiful. All right. Well, we're going to hold the line. Well, that is going to wrap it up for us here. Brother Wayne Chandler, I want to definitely thank you again for coming on. It's always a pleasure to have you in the house. And definitely want everyone to know that you can reach out to Brother Wayne Chandler by going to waynebchandler@gmail.com or waynechandler.com, and you can get the details in the show notes and find out more about one-on-one sessions if you want to get that, as well as the retreat that's coming up. So I want to say thank you so much. I know you're busy, and I love it that you definitely wanted to reach out and come on, because we love to have you come on anytime you like. So I'm.
It was beautiful. I love being here.
Well, we love having you here. So I want you to, if you could, Brother Wayne Chandler, just leave us with one little thing. You dropped so many jewels tonight, but if there's something else you want to just leave us with as we close out here tonight.
Just Kachari Mudra, You know, because that's such a powerful
practice. Yes, it is.
And it's something that everybody can do. And it's really the first level of self-integration. And when you talk about self-integration in that means and manner, you know, you're talking about how one connects energetically to just universal flow and frequency.
Yes.
So Kachari Mudra, when done, is taking the very tip of the tongue and just putting it anywhere along the ridge that runs along the roof of the mouth. And in doing that, you're connecting two circuits. You're connecting a yang or masculine to a yin or feminine circuit. Feminine or the yin circuit runs down the front of the body. The yang circuit runs up the back of the body. You know, so when you take the tip of the tongue and you connect it to that ridge that runs along the roof of the mouth, you literally connect these two circuits, and energy now moves and creates a frequency where you can actually reach out and you can begin to sense the energy frequencies of other things around you, as well as just having that tongue connection will change and alter the way your day flows, because it puts you in synchronicity with universal flow, as opposed to you struggling to trying to like make your way through this three-dimensional constructual design that has its own plans, you know, set up for how you, you know, how it wants to have your day unfold.
Powerful. Well, thank you so much for that, Brother Wayne Chandler. And we're going to get ready to get out of here. It's been an amazing share tonight. Don't forget, everyone, to download. And go over to social media, whether that is on Instagram or whether over on Facebook, and leave a detailed comment or right here on YouTube about your top three takeaways from tonight's share. So peace and love to you guys, Ashe to the ancestors, and keep your head to the sky.
Ashe.
He said